Hello there, and welcome to this episode of the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm. I'm Alan Waddell, and joined as always by the athletic director here at Southeastern Louisiana University, JRTs. And we're here at North Oak Park. And Jay, we were talking before the program started of how nice this facility is, one of the top softball facilities, not only in the Southland Conference, but in the country. And Coach Pete Langlois and his softball team's off to a 5-1 Southland Conference start.
Yeah, Pete's done a super job with our girls this year. If you've been out to North Oak Park this year and you kind of see the excitement there is and the energy the girls are playing with. But you're right, this facility is second to none. If you go look at the indoor facility we have combined with this park here, it's fantastic.
All right, well, let's talk a little bit about basketball as it just finished up. The Yolanda Moore and Jay Ladner first years are over. I know there's always the biggest improvement as a coach is between your first and second year. Really excited to see what type of players these two coaches bring in the offseason as they look to improve for next year's campaign.
Yeah, you know, the first year when new coaches come in, it's changing attitude, yep. Changing mentality, kind of get some kids in here that fit your personality, so to speak. And they had a lot of cleaning up to do. Both the men's and women's programs were really down, and they had to clean them up, and they did a good job of laying that foundation for the future.
All right, let's talk about baseball a little bit. Coach Matt Reiser is off to a 15-6 start, 4-2 in the Southland Conference. Coming up on the program, we're going to show you some highlights against Abilene Christian, where Kyle Senatal has absolutely been dominant. And I think, Jay, early on in the year, I think the big theme for Southeastern baseball is starting pitching has been tremendous.
Yeah, it has been. I'll tell you, it's been doing a great job getting us late in the ball game. And Kyle was outstanding the other night, if you watched him pitch the other night. But all of our starters, Jake Johnson did a super job. Tate Ciano is always steady getting out there. And you want your starters to go deep and give you a chance to win, and they're definitely doing that for us.
I want to ask you, too, just as a former baseball coach here at Southeastern, obviously a ton of knowledge about it. I know one of the big things that's been brought up is the lower seams on the baseball. We're seeing offensive numbers go up a little bit. Southeastern's offensive numbers are outstanding, over 300 team batting average. Do you think that's a big difference, or is it the ball, or is it just the players are better this year?
It is. You know, the ball's definitely making it fly, because you look all over the country, the numbers are up, home runs, the numbers are up, average, talking to different coaches, hearing them talk about it. You know, the dot ball is definitely flying faster. You know, ground balls are getting through more that wouldn't get through before. Fly balls are carrying a little bit further and getting a gap or hitting out of the park. So the numbers are definitely up, and the ball's made a big, big difference, which is good for college baseball.
All right, let's talk about it. March 28th, Super Lions Saturday, as we have a full day on tap for you. You got softball, you got baseball, you got the spring football game, you got the 5K run. It's one of those days you can just put your green and gold on, come to the campus, and hang out all day. There's a lot of things going on, and very excited for that day once again.
Yeah, Super Lions Saturday is a tradition we started a year ago, and it was really good last year to kick off. We got the 5K run in the morning. Hopefully everybody come out and try to participate in that, but whatever you're interested in, whether softball, baseball, football, whatever it may be, if you're just a Lion fan in general, we've got a tailgate, and Gusso Krepke sponsoring a tailgate for us, and that's what it's all about, getting people out here and getting them to be a part of Lion Nation.
And I know one thing, there's a lot of buzz around Lion football once again, coming off of back-to-back Southland Conference championships. They had a spring scrimmage the other day, and there was a good crowd and some good performances of some guys I think that will become household names here for Southeastern.
No question. Very athletic group. If you saw us play, kids flying around, it's good to see those guys out there again.
And, Coach, before I let you go, we also don't want to fail to mention a young lady on campus that has been absolutely dominant, Renee Villavarey. 47-4 in her career here at Southeastern, just dominating on the tennis court.
Tennis team's having another great season. Yep. You know, Jason Hayes is doing a super job with our girls. Renee's been outstanding. I mean, she's steady every time she goes on court, gives us a chance to win, and they're fun to watch.
All right, well, let's go ahead and take a break. When we come back, we're going to get to all the highlights right here on the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Come over here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We are never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
This is Sean. We saw him holding a Bud Light, which means he's up for whatever happens. In this case, Jimmy Johnson.
I, Jimmy Johnson, challenge you to a little football game.
Don't get nervous.
Are we ready?
I'm ready. Jimmy Johnson has dominated the electric football circuit.
Yeah, look at the little Jimmy run.
He's hurt.
He's pushing through.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. It's a winner.
Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens.
Welcome back to the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm. I want to thank JRT's athletic director here at Southeastern Louisiana University for stopping by and spending some time with us, as he does every week on our program, to catch us up on what you need to know about Southeastern athletics. We're going to start the highlight portion of our show this week by checking in with the softball team, who's off to a hot start in Southland Conference play. Here's the action.
Game two of a doubleheader in Southland Conference action between the Lady Lions and Incarnate Word. After Southeastern took the opener, Incarnate Word gets off to a good start. Although Danielle Ramirez called out for stepping on home plate on that base hit. That brought out Alex Cepeda, lines one into right center field. Tori Stamper in the circle for Southeastern, induces a ground ball to Kristen Hebert for a second out, and then strikes out Alex Alonzo to get out the top of the first. Southeastern starts things off well as Katie LaCour, speedy leadoff hitter, gets on an error and moves to second when Kenzie Nichols, freshman left fielder, just misses beating out an infield hit. Sydney Booker moves LaCour over to third on a ground out. That brings up Amber Sather, who hits a hard line shot, but she's robbed by shortstop Lindsay Hood. And Southeastern goes scoreless in the bottom of the first. Sheldon Swenson gets hit by a Stamper pitch to start things off in the first, and then Brooke Dubois, the pitcher, bunts Swenson over to second. And that brings up Lindsay Hood, who lines one through the right side. And Cardinals are in business with runners in the corners with one out. And that brings up catcher Christy Trevino, that swung a hot bat all series for Incarnate Word, and she drives in the game's first run. And again, runners are at the corners. Then Stamper gets some fortunate luck as she's right there for the liner off the bat of Danielle Ramirez. Get out of the inning. And Lacey Fritz leads off the second for Southeastern, hits one off the wall, nearly clears the wall, and she races in for a double. She's left there as actually pinch runner Grace DeLee moves to third on a ground out by Katie LaCour, and then Dubois plunks Nichols to put runners on the corners, but she gets out of the jam as Booker grounds out short. Lindsay Hood lifts one deep to left, but freshman Kenzie Nichols is right there on the warning track to catch that ball. Amber Sather draws a walk. Junior is leading the Southland Conference in walks. And then freshman Peyton Stokes Sutton's bunted over to second by Teresa Lamos. And advances to third on a ground out by Megan Moore. Sloan Jenkins hits one right up the middle, but Dubois is able to snag it. And again, Southeastern leaves runners stranded. Vanessa Ng gets fortunate as Hood misplays her ground ball. Get things started. And speedy Katie LaCour beats out a bunt single to put a pair of runners on. That would bring up Sydney Booker, who hits one right at the right fielder, and she just misplays it. LaCour and Kenzie Nichols both race home and give Southeastern a 2-1 lead. Amber Sather with a chance to add to it, but Dubois gets her swinging to keep the deficit at one run. From there, that's all Stamper would need. She gets Hood to ground out to Booker. And then for the final out, Trevino hits one over to Megan Moore, and Southeastern completes the doubleheader sweep with a 2-1 victory after winning the opening game 5-4 in 8 innings. On Sunday, they would go on to complete the series sweep with a 5-4, 9-inning victory over the Cardinals. Ley Lions now 5-1 in conference play, their best start to conference play since 2001.
Congratulations to the Southeastern softball program for sweeping Incarnate Word and starting out the 2015 Southland Conference schedule 5-1 here early on. We're now going to switch our attention to the Southeastern tennis program as the number one player for the Lady Lions continues her dominance.
Southeastern Louisiana junior tennis player Renee Villarreal has been nothing short of fantastic ever since she arrived on the Southeastern campus in the fall of 2012.
What I thought at first, it was a big opportunity for me to be here, so I had to take every chance that I had and every opportunity. I had to get the most out of it because I knew that how the fall went, it was going to determine how my spring was going to be. And I really liked my team captain. She really motivated me. She was taking me through the next level all the time. And if I had any troubles or any questions, I would ask her and I would look up to her. And she basically told me that you have to give your best every single day, even at practice, at school, because if you don't do it at school, why? It changes how you perform in tennis.
When she came on her visit, she had just a great sense about her. I mean, she was very friendly, very outgoing, and you could tell, I mean, we wanted to make sure that we got her to Southeastern. And when she came in, we thought she was going to be a good player. I mean, she had the best timing I've ever seen of anybody hit the ball. But we didn't think she was going to be as good as she turned out to be.
Her freshman season, Renee was named first team All Southland Conference in all Louisiana after one of the most productive seasons in school history. Renee did not lose a singles match in the regular season, finishing her freshman year with a 22-1 record. Renee earned Southland Conference number 3 singles individual champion accolades after posting a 9-0 singles mark in league play. Her 22 single wins were tied for the second most in school history. Renee teamed with Adriana Castillo for a 17-3 doubles mark and also tied for the second most doubles victories in school history. She was named Southland Conference Player of the Week on 2 occasions during her freshman season.
You know, she started at 5 her freshman year, and then we lost Sarah to an injury, so she moved to 4. She played great at 4. We moved her to 3, and she just blossomed at 3. And then, you know, we knew she was going to be a good player, but we had no idea she was going to be as dominant as she is.
And then I moved up to 4. I was kind of feeling nervous about it, you know, having more pressure. I was going to get pretty tough matches. I don't know if I was going to be able to remain undefeated. And then I moved up to 3. I had a little bit more pressure. I was a little bit more nervous. But I said, like, hey, you're already here. Like, just do whatever you can. And if you can remain undefeated, well, that's great. But if not, well, you just keep. There can be only one singles match loss, so you can win the rest.
In 2014, Renee earned first team All Southland Conference and All Louisiana honors for the second straight season. She recorded a 16-3 record in her first season at number 1 singles and was named Southland Conference Player of the Week on March 11th. Renee posted singles win streaks of 9-6 matches during the spring and was 12-4 in doubles play with 4 different partners. An outstanding student, she was also named First Team Casita Academic All-District 6 and Southland Conference All-Academic. She shared 2013-14 Southeastern Female Athlete of the Year honors with soccer's Hope Sabadash.
During her freshman year and her sophomore year, she got to play for 2 great team captains. And now she's the captain, and you know, she's kind of taken the best that she learned from Issa and the best that she learned from Adriana, and she's taken this team under her wing. And for a coach, that's great, because I don't have to worry about them. I mean, I know exactly what she's going to do. She's going to get them fired up. She's going to get them excited to play. And then she's going to show them through her examples of how things you know, need to be done.
So far this spring, Renee is 8-0 at number 1 singles. Villarreal gave the Lions a 2-0 lead on the number 1 court recently as the Lady Lions hosted Bradley. Renee is now 47-4 in her career as a Lion. She overwhelmed Bradley's number 1 singles player, Alexa Brandt, 6-4, 6-0. Renee and the Lady Lions are 6-2 so far this year and 2-1 in league play as they continue to push for a spot in the Southland Conference tournament.
I really think that the 4 new freshmen that we have, they are unbelievably good. They want to give their best every time they're here. They want to practice. They want to become better every time. And I am 8-0, and I plan, if I can, to keep on increasing that undefeated. You know, conference matches are coming, and they're starting to be tougher and tougher. I'm playing people that I haven't played before. You know, you don't know what you can expect, but if you always give your best, you know that for sure you won't regret that you have lost if I would at any point in time.
Congratulations once again to Renee, an outstanding 47-4 in her Southeastern career. All right, let's take a break. When we come back, we'll have more for you right here on the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm.
I want the pump. You up.
No. You want the pump. You up. Like
that's
that.
It.
You put the emphasis on the wrong syllable.
I want the pump. You up.
I'm not going to sugarcoat it. That was terrible.
This is not a joke. Let's try it again.
I want the pump. You up.
It's like we're talking to a wall.
Yeah. I don't know what kind of sick game you're playing.
Knock, knock. Hello.
I want the pump. You up.
I can't do this anymore.
Training is hard. Saving is easy. Get a discount double check today.
This is Sean. We saw him holding a Bud Light, which means he's up for whatever happens. In this case, Jimmy Johnson.
I, Jimmy Johnson, challenge you to a little football game. Don't get nervous.
Are we ready?
I'm ready. Jimmy Johnson has dominated the electric football circuit.
Yeah, look at the little Jimmy run. He's hurt.
He's pushing through.
Oh, wait a minute. It's a winner.
Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens.
Welcome back to the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm. Recently, the Southeastern women's basketball program finished up their season as it was senior day against Nicholls State at the UC. Voice of the Lions, Lance Pittman, has the call.
From Anchorage, Alaska, number 34, Adrina LaBeau. Ladies and gentlemen, from Los Angeles, California, number 4, Anessa from Miami, Mississippi, number 23, Tamika Hoskins. Ladies and gentlemen, from Savannah, Georgia, number 11, Elizabeth Stiles.
Right wing, threw it in the middle, steal by Stiles. Got a two-on-one. Stiles going to take it all the way, though. She'll lay it up and in. There's 2 points for Elizabeth. She's 13 away, and the Lady Lions lead 2-0. 30 minutes gone by. To Stiles in the floor. Crossed the way to Miller. Miller sets up three ball on the way here. Yes! And Miller's to within 15. Goes on top, 11-9. Hoskins down the floor, near side. Laverne, layup good. She's got four. In the corner, Laverne sets up for three. Hit it! She's got six of the 14. Poole to Dela Cruz to Stiles. In the corner, Hoskins. Hoskins bounce pass to Poole. Poole, little head fake. Up off the glass. That one good. And the Lady Lions on look. Stiles going to drive, get around her man. She'll pull up, get hand off Stewart. Stewart's jumper is good. Long rebound out. Stiles in the middle of the floor. Top of the key. Free throw line going to stop. She'll pop a three. Hit it. Anderson right wing down to Dela Cruz. Dela Cruz 15-footer. That one good. They go to Hernandez to Stiles. Stiles with the shot clock at five. Going to take it all the way. Lay it up and in. There it is. 15-point. 1,000 for her career. Little driving layup by Stiles there. She's got 15. Stiles out on the right side to Anderson. Anderson, a couple of dribbles into the free throw line, into Dela Cruz. Dela Cruz with a 15-footer, hit it. Left-handed jumper from the baseline, and Hoskins picks it up. Lady Lions got the numbers, 2-on-1. Hoskins will take it herself, lay it up, good, and one. Fake the pass to Stiles, got it to go, and drew the foul. Trying to set her feet, give and go Underwood. Underwood with a jumper on the way, bounces around and in. Talen with the bucket. Screen by Hoskins, top of the key. Now to Hernandez. Hernandez can't shoot. Back to Stiles. Two, three at the buzzer. In and out, won't go. Final score tonight, Nichols 77, Southeastern 74.
For all the Southeastern fans out there, I want to thank these five senior ladies for their service to Southeastern Athletics and Southeastern Women's Basketball. We're now going to check in with the men's basketball team as they qualified for the Southland Conference Tournament and took on McNeese State. Here's the highlights.
McNeese State for their first possession of Merrill Madness. Quick three, Keelan Garrett in the first points of the Southland Conference Basketball. Keelan Garrett on Southeastern side of the ball is all about Cedric Jenkins. On the mark, friendly.
8 minutes in. The Southeastern looking to slow things down. They play zone here. Only eight active players on the Lions roster.
Keelan Garrett is third three. But most seasons, this team wouldn't be in the tournament to begin with. As Cedric Jenkins.
This team has given great effort. They continue to battle, and they have here. Undermanned and now just down two.
And then you add quite a significant group of freshman players. Official score sheet, official statistics do say two.
It does say two. Okay.
This has been changed since
the Lions have a chance to take their first lead here. And here's Jenkins with a left hand. 7-2. Challenging Garrett. Too short. Lewis got the ball knocked away. Jenkins the two and the foul. Hardy tripled inside. Boy, what a tremendous one. Them both. Just by five in Lake Charles, February the 16th.
Ups it off the glass and good, and he'll do it some more.
From the corner, Sean Johnson.
He's getting a quick breather.
Here's Greaves with four to shoot.
Big three, and the Lions up. Sometimes the men's one inside are separated, but McNeese, it truly is close.
Sean Johnson again. Greaves. Big three. Both teams exchanging threes now. Jenkins gets by Lewis. Inside to Upson. 4-point lead. And now Southeastern.
Digital network. And if so, glad to have you guys along. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow here in the building.
What a move by Hardy. Now he's on the drive. Three to shoot. Jenkins wants it off his foot. Sean Johnson with it. And then Greaves knocks it away. And a foul.
Here we go.
Johnson got it blocked. Hardy couldn't get the follow up in time. The rebound. Lewis, the emphatic follow. For the tie. Keys kept shooting and shooting, and he finally
their
got
best 3-point shooter on the floor is Jenkins,
but he gets the ball inside, and Lewis the block, taken away Johnson, and McNeese State survives.
Tough break for the men's basketball team in the Southland Conference Tournament as that game went all the way to overtime against McNeese State as the season ends for Coach Jay Ladner in his first year here at Southeastern, and by judging by some of the mid-year signees and the recruiting class they're putting together, ought to be a strong team on the court next year for Southeastern's basketball. Let's go ahead and take a break. When we come back, we'll have more right here on the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Come over here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those.
We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
Welcome back to the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm. Recently, the Southeastern baseball team hosted Abilene Christian for a Southland Conference weekend. And after splitting the first two games of the series, on Sunday, Kyle Sedatall was dominant on the mound. Here's the highlights. Come back out for Sunday and to take on Abilene Christian, the rubber match in this one. And Matt, I'll tell you, this was an absolute perfect day for baseball. Maybe the best weather we've had all year.
It was by far the best weather we've had all year. And it was great to finally get a little bit of the baseball atmosphere. We got kids at the park day. You see all of them running on the field there. And let's be honest, the story of the day wasn't the weather. It was Kyle Sedatall. It was absolutely phenomenal from the get-go on this thing. And You saw he had his off-speed going there with his cutter and really located all three pitches, curveball, his cutter, and his fastball. Even had his changeup going as well, so really four pitches, and did a fantastic job for us.
Ryan Byers with the walk, still second, and then sets you up with a two-out scoring opportunity, and Kenan Menard comes through with the big two-out knock.
Yeah, you know, Kenan hasn't been starting a ton for us. Got the nod all weekend there at shortstop and did an absolute fabulous job for us of just coming up big for us with the two-out knock. They misplayed there in left field. Was hoping to maybe score Kenan. Don't get a chance to score him. Gets here to third. Does a good job of getting the third because then they get a little squibber in the infield, and Seward beats it out for base hit and RBI.
Yeah, that's one of those things where maybe earlier in the year, Seward would square one up and wouldn't get a hit. And when it's going good for a guy, it all goes good. As steals the bag right here after the little squibber. And
then the ground up.
Get out of the inning.
Yeah, but it wasn't before the damage was done. We scored four runs there in the second inning. We're up 4-0. And again, Kyle said it all, gets to go on cruise control. The break and the pitches you see he's got on his pitches, did a fantastic job of just dominating the strike zone. Ended up striking out 14 on the day, not walking one single person. And like you said, when it's kind of going all right, it's going all right. See Kevin Carr making a play over at first base. We've had a couple issues there catching that fly ball. Does a good job of making a play, and then after the play, obviously he comes back up and gets the big base knock to get another inning going for us.
They weren't getting anything going against Kyle, I'll tell you. I was sitting in the stands and thinking to myself, man, first of all, do they have any hits? And second of all, man, it seems like he's striking everybody out.
Yeah, you know, like we said, the offense had a good day, but the story of the day was Kyle Stedetal. And you see, I think this was probably our most complete game we've played all season from an offensive standpoint, from a defensive standpoint, from a pitcher standpoint. We had just a great day. And another guy who hasn't been on lineup much, Jacob Williams. Does a fantastic job there with a big two-out knock. A
couple hits on the day.
Yeah, had a couple knocks. You know, he's hitting 500 for us now. And takes second base after a miscue there defensively for them. And allows Midget to come back up, and we just keep pulling it on.
As you can see, Lions keep scoring. Abilene does not. And Coach Kyle would not give up a hit until 6 2/3 into this ball game. This was absolutely dominant. Complete game, 7 innings. It ended by the mercy rule. A 2-hit shutout. 14 strikeouts for Kyle Stedetal. He has really settled into that Sunday role.
So as you can see, Kyle Stedetal was absolutely dominant in this one. 2 hits, 14 strikeouts, no walks, earned him Louisiana Sports Writers Association Player of the Week and also National Player of the Week for Kyle Stedetal. The Lions baseball team currently sits at 15-6, 4-2 in the Southland Conference, off to a great start here in 2015. That's going to do it for us. Thank you so much for joining us here on the Southeastern Sports Report presented by State Farm.